Yes, he does.
Yes.
Yeah, and you know what? We kind of know it's him too, don't we?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Chapter 7, verses 9 through 12. I'm going to read. When Pharaoh shall speak unto you, saying, show us a miracle. How many of y'all need a miracle?
Amen. Amen.
You know, they say the word miracle is not in the Bible. So I want you all to take notation to where this is.
Right.
Exodus chapter 7 and verse 9.
Amen.
It mentions of the word miracle. Amen. How many of you know a miracle? The definition of miracle is something that cannot happen by human
means.
Anybody in here need a miracle night?
Amen. Amen.
Yeah. Yeah. When Pharaoh shall speak unto you, said, show us a miracle for you. Then shall thou say to Aaron, take the rod and cast it before Pharaoh, and it shall become a serpent. And Moses and Aaron went in unto Pharaoh, and they did so as the Lord had commanded, and Aaron cast down his rod before Pharaoh, and it became his servant, and it became a serpent. Then Pharaoh also called the wise men, supposed to be wise. How many of you know a lot of us think we're wise?
Amen.
But when we have the worldly wisdom, everybody said worldly wisdom.
Worldly wisdom.
We find that later. It's not the type of wisdom
that's right.
that we need. If there were call for
that's
the wise
right.
men
that's
and
right.
the sorcerers, now the physicians and of Egypt, they also did like manner with their own enchantments. For they cast down every man's rod and they became serpents. But Aaron's rod did what?
Oh,
how many of you know that I am what I am got more power than the devil?
Amen.
It said it swallowed up.
Uh-huh.
Go to chapter 8, verse 1. And the Lord spake. Everybody say, sometimes I need to hear from God. And the Lord spake unto Moses. This is why even the preachers and the pastors need to stand before
That's
God
right.
before they bring
That's
a word to the people. Amen. Because the people don't need to hear your word.
Right.
They need to hear a word from God.
Amen.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, go unto Pharaoh and say unto him, thus saith the Lord, let my people go. That they may serve me. How many of you know that when God delivers you, He don't deliver you to serve your car on Sunday and
all right,
God delivers you, He delivers you to serve Him.
Amen.
Oh, aren't you glad about it?
Yeah.
He delivers you so that you can tell somebody, I once was lost.
Yeah. I once was lost.
Now I'm fine.
Yeah.
I'm fine. He delivers you to be able to tell somebody, He is my doctor in my sick room.
Yeah.
He will be a lawyer in a courtroom.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God.
Everybody say,
say I am.
Now, I'm the type of teacher, and this is the way God works for me.
Amen.
I just gave you a biblical character, which was Pharaoh, about the great I am. Now I'm going to give you a natural example of a natural character that knew how to use the great I am.
Amen.
Listen to somebody say, it's good to learn about biblical characters.
Right.
But I need to also know
how I
can use the great I am.
Can use the great I am.
In my life.
In my life.
Can I get a witness?
Amen. Praise God.
Somebody say, I am.
I am.
I am.
I am. I am.
That I am.
I am.
The character that I chose to use, natural, is Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali kept saying, I am the greatest. Is that what he said?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I am
the
greatest. A lot of people didn't know that kings would use the word, the phrase, I am, as part of their name, signifying power.
Amen.
And he would say, I am the greatest. Yes. And most of us know that his real name was not Muhammad Ali.
Right. Mm-hmm.
It was Cassius Clay.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And when he went to Africa to fight George Foreman, that great, you know, he was a big man, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm.
But guess what? He believed in the I am.
Amen. Praise God.
In him. That the I am would give him strength.
Uh-huh.
And he would begin to use, Ricky, the power of the spoken word while he was fighting his opponent. Oh, y'all come on and go. Y'all know what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
And he used to talk back to his opponent. And he would call him, you big old ugly bear.
Yeah.
How many of you know we need to tell the devil sometimes, you just a big old ugly bear. You ain't nothing but a coward. How many of you know the devil wants to make us think that he has all power?
Give it to
God told us in Genesis that I gave you power over the fowls of the air.
Amen.
Over the fish of
the sea.
Over every creeping place upon the earth. And he kept on talking to George Foreman while they were in the ring saying, you big old ugly bear. You just an ugly something. And he began to talk to him. He said, you ain't nothing. How many of you know sometimes we need to talk to the devil like that?
Amen.
You ain't nothing, Satan. Oh, you've been messing with my body, but that's okay. God promised me in his word that I am the Lord thy healer.
Amen. Praise God.
The Bible says, greater is he.
That's
the word.
Greater
is he. That is not the outside of us. That is in me. That is the word.
Amen.
And we ought to tell that devil, leave my children alone.
Amen.
Leave my grandchildren alone.
Amen.
Because the I am in me is greater.
Glory.
And a lot of times, if y'all remember that fight, Muhammad Ali would keep on leaning on the rail with this fight. And they kept telling him, get off the rail. Anybody remember? Get off the rail. But he let George from use up all of his strength. And he kept on punching him. He stayed up against the rail. Because he said, I know after a while he going to get
tired.
And so he stayed up against the rail. Look at somebody say, your spiritual rail.
Your spiritual rail.
It's the word of God.
It's the word of God.
Lean on the word of God.
Lean on the word of God.
That was my
hallelujah.
Stay up against the rail.
Yeah.
Say, I'm going to stay in the word. Because God going to show that the word.
Yeah.
I'm
going to
keep on touching you. Say, I'm going to stay in the word.
I'm going to stay in the word.
I don't see no way being made. I'm going to stay up against the rail.
Yeah.
He wasn't leaning on a weak rail.
Right.
The rail Muhammad Ali was leading on was a strong rail.
Hey,
I'm a strong tower.
I'm a tower.
I am.
I am.
See, you gotta first see what the devil was trying to do. Muhammad Ali, Mother Hope, was able to see that he kept trying to punch at him, to wear him down. How many of you know you gotta be able to spiritually and naturally see what the devil is trying to do?
Amen.
When he messes with your children, when he messes with your body, what he wants to do is grab a hold of your joy. He wants to strip you of your joy through the trials and the tribulations. But look at your mind and say, I can't never take my joy. And when you see what the devil's trying to do, you see he's trying to make you have the wrong attitude. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Oh, somebody say amen.
Amen.
You see this, you say, oh no, I might want to act like that, but I can't. I say I'm a Christian now. I might want to cuss somebody out. Come on, y'all. Hey, I can't act like that.
I can't act like that.
You say I'm a Christian now. I might want to have a nasty attitude. I can't act like that now. Because I say I'm a Christian now. Oh, somebody say amen. I might want to spread seeds of discord among the brethren, but I can't do that now because I claim to be a Christian now. Oh, y'all quiet in here. When you're on God's side, you say, I might want to sleep with somebody else's husband. I might want to sleep with somebody else's wife. But I can't do that now because I'm a Christian now.
Praise God.
See, Muhammad Ali began to talk to the God on the inside. And he knows that I am. That I am, that I say I am.
Amen.
You got to do this thing the right way.
Amen.
So it goes on to say, and this, I'll say it was about round three. And God said, okay, Pharaoh, you're not going to even get to round 12 because you keep messing with my child.
Amen.
So I'm going to stop this at round 9. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
See, if you keep on messing with God's children, look at somebody and tell them it's not good.
It's not good.
You keep messing with God's children.
Amen.
Amen.